Recently, our Bank of Canada governor has said that the U.S. president's protectionist policies could cause a global recession. I'm wondering whether or not, in your career, have you seen the influence of politics in this magnitude on markets and on global markets?
It's pretty unprecedented right now to see the markets so confused by Donald Trump. A lot of his ideas on things like trade are unorthodox, to put it mildly. At the same time, I would say that the markets have affected Trump. I think Trump views the stock market as the ultimate arbiter of whether he's doing well or not. So he doesn't want to do things to make the markets upset, which is why I think we'll get a trade deal.
Donald Trump has recently asked for the Federal Reserve for a 100 basis point rate reduction. I guess wondering about that overt behavior from a president to the Federal Reserve, because I think, if I can borrow a word from you, that's unprecedented.
Trump does a lot of things that are very unprecedented, way outside the box. That's just Donald J. Trump. But I think the idea that he could intimidate the Fed is ridiculous. The markets might. I think the markets basically said to Jerome Powell, the chairman, enough is enough on the tightening. And Powell got the message. And I think the markets have had an impact on some other policies that Trump does pay attention to. But at the same time, I would say that the Fed will stay independent.
Now, what would a rate reduction of that capacity do to the markets?
Well, a 100 basis point rate reduction, which is unfathomable to me, I think would first and foremost worry the markets that the Fed no longer has its independence. I think beyond that, it would make the dollar a lot weaker. It would probably drive interest rates sharply lower. Might be good for the stock market, but markets don't like to be surprised. And if the Fed were to do anything, a rate cut or maybe even a rate hike this winter, it would be in a small increment, a 25 basis points, nothing bigger or smaller.
What's going to stimulate inflation in the U.S.?
Well, one thing that I think has to worry the Fed is the labor market. We have an unusually low unemployment rate, 3.8%. It might go down even more in the next few months. If we're at 3.4 or 3.5 in the fall on our unemployment rate, it could finally lead to real pressure on wages. And any central banker in any country in the world will tell you the most intractable inflation is wage inflation, not energy, not food. If wage inflation gets into the system, that's something the Fed would have to worry about.
So there's an unusually low unemployment rate, I guess at a 50-year low.
Yeah.
GDP is at 3.2% for the first quarter,
yeah,
I believe. Roaring economy, what does this roadmap to re-election look like for the president? I mean, is this economy going to overheat? Are we looking at a recession in 2020? What does that look like for re-election?
Well, I'm out on a limb saying the economy will clearly surprise to the upside, might even overheat, because we have so much stimulus. Monetary policy is so loose. Fiscal policy is very stimulative. We're spending like drunken sailors right now in Washington. So I think with a really strong economy, Trump has a plus, no question about it. He can, I think, run a re-election campaign with that as his main theme. But it doesn't work for everybody. There are some areas of the country, Pennsylvania, a crucial battleground state, for example, has people who have not benefited from a strong economy. They're still not happy with their jobs or with their salaries. Trump can boast that the stock market has done quite well. We're at record highs. But again, some people in rural Pennsylvania, blue-collar workers, have not participated in the stock rally. So it's not a 100% winner for Trump, and there are other issues, health care, climate change. There are other issues that may cut against him.
Is Joe Biden a threat?
I think Biden right now is the front runner. I think a lot of Democrats question his age. He's from a different generation. He's not known to have a lot of new ideas, but most Democrats view him as the most likely candidate to beat Trump, and that's a huge plus that Biden has. Is he a threat to Trump? Yeah, Trump has tweeted so aggressively and mockingly toward Biden that it shows that already Biden's gotten under Trump's skin, and Trump realizes that Biden is a threat.
The U.S.-China trade talks are set to resume. Do you foresee a deal in the near future, number one?
Yeah.
And what does that trade deal look like? I mean, ultimately, the U.S. cannot enforce China to comply, can they?
Well, two things. Number one, I do think we'll get a deal within the next few weeks. I think Donald Trump needs it for his reelection. He needs the markets to be happy about no trade war. And I think Xi in China needs it. The Chinese economy is looking a little rocky right now. So I do think we'll get a deal by the end of May, a signing ceremony. But the other question that you bring up is the more important one, in my opinion. What kind of a deal will it be? Will it be kind of cosmetic and China will say we'll buy a lot of U.S. products, we'll say we lift some tariffs? That's fine. It might reduce our overall trade imbalance. But will the deal have structural reforms? Will the deal look at China's thievery of our intellectual property? Will it look at China's subsidies for state-owned companies? Will there be an effective enforcement mechanism? A lot of unknowns, and the jury is out on just how meaningful the structural reforms might be.
I want to bring it to this side of the divide because recent comments by Senator Chuck Grassley have indicated that unless the U.S. president removes steel and aluminum tariffs, there will be no USMCA deal or otherwise known as the new NAFTA deal.
I'm generally optimistic about things right now, but I'm not optimistic about lifting the aluminum and steel tariffs that are imposed on Canada and Mexico and some other countries. Trump views tariffs as a club, a bargaining chip, and I don't think we're close to getting approval of the NAFTA replacement. And it looks to me as if Democrats in the House, headed by Nancy Pelosi, want changes. They want changes on labor standards, on environmental standards, and I just don't think the votes are there. Bottom line, we may not get this new trade deal approved this year. And as long as it's not approved, we probably won't have the steel and aluminum tariffs lifted.